At least once, you've probably heard someone say, "One man's trash is another man's treasure." That's something that always rang true to me. And if your business or organization creates potentially hazardous types of trash or waste, like used chemicals or oils, cleaning solvents, wastewaters, even aerosols, batteries, old electronics, and so on, this trash treasure maxim can be a valuable one to keep in mind. I'm Roger with Lion Technology, and it's time to answer another important question for anyone who's new to hazardous waste management or wants to better understand the Resource Conservation and Recovery Act, or RCRA, regulations. That question is, when does a material become a waste? When does a chemical in a bottle, for example, go from a product that I can use to a waste that I potentially need to store and track and dispose of according to specific regulations? Because when our material is not a waste, now, we could have more flexibility in how we manage it or how we use it on site. And we could save ourselves a little treasure along the way. When we talk about waste in the context of RCRA, the word refers to an enormous range of stuff that EPA calls solid waste. Understanding what is or is not a solid waste is hugely important because solid waste is an umbrella term in the regulations, and all hazardous waste falls under that umbrella. That means if we want to know if something is a hazardous waste, we first need to know, is it a solid waste? It also means that if a material is not a solid waste, then it is not a hazardous waste according to the RCRA regulations. Now, don't be misled by the term solid waste. You can see in the legal definition on screen that a solid waste can be a solid or a liquid, a semi-solid, or a gas. Don't get hung up on every word of this definition, at least not now. If you know Lion Technology, you know that we like to simplify things to see more clearly what these laws and regulations are really saying. So, there are four ways for a material to be a solid waste. First, a material is a solid waste if it is abandoned. That means you dispose of it, you burn it or incinerate it, or if you store it on site before you dispose of it or incinerate it. Second, a material is a solid waste if it is recycled in certain ways. Now, this will vary based on the type of material, its properties, and the method of recycling. So, a material may be a solid waste if you burn it as fuel, for example, but not considered a solid waste if you distill it to recover some product that you can reuse. Third, a material is a solid waste if it fits the criteria for what EPA calls an inherently waste-like material. That shakes out to include certain toxic byproducts from specific industrial processes. The fourth way something can be a solid waste is if that something is a military munition under some circumstances. An example of when a munition is a solid waste is when it is, quote, deteriorated or damaged to the point that it cannot be put into serviceable condition and cannot reasonably be recycled or used for other purposes. I told you that solid waste is an umbrella term and that all hazardous waste falls under that umbrella. So, now that we know how to identify a solid waste, we are past the first hurdle to identify a hazardous waste. If we determined our material is a solid waste, now we can evaluate it further to determine if it meets any of the RCRA criteria for regulation as a hazardous waste based on things like its physical and chemical properties, any hazards it presents, or what industry sector or what specific process it came from. On the other hand, if our material is not a solid waste, well, then we're done with waste ID. We know that if it's not a solid waste, then it is not a hazardous waste. From the perspective of compliance with hazardous waste regulations, when something is not a hazardous waste, well, that's something to really treasure. Thank you for taking time to watch this video. Please, if you learned something or gained some new perspective, hit the like button, add a comment below, or share this video with someone who you know who could use it. If you want to learn more about how to identify and manage hazardous waste and operate your site in compliance with current regulations, here are three things that you can do right now. Check out the free resources linked in the video description for more essential details about RCRA and RCRA training. Subscribe to Lion's YouTube channel to catch our next FAQ video, and visit lion.com/RCRA to browse upcoming workshops, live webinars, and self-paced online training for professionals at any level of experience or responsibility. That includes initial training for new employees and refresher training required annually for personnel at large quantity generator facilities. Check out the website for course agendas, schedules, and options for training as a group, either in person or online. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you in the next video.